What's up, guys? I am live here and I am at the legendary Rick Macci's Academy. He's actually taken down. He usually has all these cool signs. My favorite sign he ever had was Master Boring. He's going to be moving to a new facility. They actually built a park for him. I think it's called Rick Macci Park or something like that. He's going to be there in September. So this is probably going to be one of the last things you see out here live from this place. This is a historical place. Rick's been here for 11 years, and I came out here to take a private lesson. Guys, I took a private lesson today from Rick Macci because when I was learning tennis and starting to become a pretty decent junior player, I was learning something called the modern forehand. Well, today, what do they teach? They teach the modern forehand, but guess what? My forehand's not the modern forehand that they're hitting today. So I wanted to come on and come down here. I drove down here, 10 hours plus yesterday. Had an hour private lesson with Rick, $500 for the hour lesson. Totally worth it. Learned a lot. And the biggest thing was, is I felt a difference. And so that's what I'm gonna be working on. I'm gonna keep working on, you know, keep molding and feeling that difference and then teach you guys how I'm feeling it and how I'm doing it. That's gonna be the cool thing about this adventure. Is I'm gonna take what Rick showed me. I'm also gonna have some really great experts also help me along this journey to where I'm trying to change my forehand. I'm 46, trying to change my forehand from the old school modern forehand to the new next gen forehand, the one that you're seeing these pros hit today. And it is different than just telling yourself to shorten your swing cycle. There's different things you have to do, different positions you have to get into. One of the biggest things Rick worked with me on is saying, Pete, you gotta relax. He's like, I can tell you used to be a good player and that you were very intense, and I can tell you were a hard worker, but probably if you would have relaxed more as a junior, it's kind of interesting how he picked this out. He's like, if you would have been able to relax more, you might have gone up another two levels than where you finished at. So, you know, that was kind of cool and also right on. It was kind of sobering. It was like kind of like exciting, like, man, if I would have just relaxed, maybe I could have been a much better player. But then it was also like, that's easier said than done, right? I mean, I think that's one of the things that holds so many of us back is we get tight. And but it was just kind of interesting to see somebody who's just feeding me the ball underhand pick that up right away. And of course I was nervous taking a lesson from Rick Macci, who, thank you for the thumbs up, taking a lesson from Rick Macci, who's always been one of my idols, of course. I first learned about Rick. If you guys don't know who Rick is, I learned about Rick when I was a junior, and this great junior, Mike Sell, left us in New Jersey, came down to Rick Macci's Academy for a year, and then he came back and destroyed everybody. Went on to finish number 3 at Kalamazoo. The winner of Kalamazoo gets into the US Open, by the way. And then he went on to play number 1 for University of Georgia. He's coached people like Isner and things like that. So that's the first I heard of Rick. And then, of course, always, always good joining live. Thank you, Diego. Of course, the other thing is Rick coached the Williams sisters. He took the Williams sisters in as kids and really developed their game. I mean, of course, Richard Williams deserves a lot of credit being the architect of their game. But really, Rick was the one who developed their game, especially when we're talking about a technical standpoint. He's the one who developed their game. He developed Andy Roddick's game as a junior. He developed Maria Sharapova for some time. And now he's, of course, working with great juniors. They're actually going to be moving him. This is going to be one of the last times you see this place. He's going to be moving in September to, they have a Rick Macci Park that they're a public park. He's excited. He's going to be working with people out in the public park. He's going to be doing wheelchair tennis, senior tennis, junior development, plus working with his top level juniors. So he's super pumped and excited about it. And, you know, it was so fun to be down here with Rick and being a student of the game again. You know, I haven't had a lesson for myself to where someone's actually looking at me, going under the hood, looking at me. I haven't had a lesson for myself in probably, you know, what am I, 46? Probably over 22, 23 years. No one's looked at me and said, hey, Pete, this is what you're doing wrong. This is what you're doing right. I loved it. Oh my God, did I love it. I'm like, I have to take more lessons. I have to take more tennis lessons because I learn so much. And so that's what I'm going to be building over the next couple months. Let me know what you guys think about this. It's going to be teaching old dogs like me who maybe had a nice modern forehand or a traditional forehand, how to learn. How's it going, Chip? Chip's from Atlanta. Well, I'm from Atlanta too, but I'm actually down in Florida right now. But I'm gonna be teaching you guys how an old dog like me, who had a nice modern forehand in the 80s and 90s when I was playing, is gonna learn the new next gen. I'm calling it the new next gen modern forehand, okay? And so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm about to go on a journey. One of the assignments that Rick gave me is I gotta do 200 shadow strokes a day, 200 a day, which I'm gonna do. Cause it's all about getting that feel. And I felt it a couple times. When I felt that thing, it felt smooth, it felt effortless. It definitely felt different than any shot I had hit before. And my old forehand, it's not like it's a bad forehand, guys. It's a good forehand. But the forehand he was teaching is different, and it's what they're doing today. And that's what I want to learn, because I know you guys want to learn that stuff too. So that's it. I just want to check in with you guys. If you've never seen my videos before, my name is Pete from Crunch Time Coaching. I'm on a mission to help you guys improve your tennis game. And I think one thing I'm going to do more and more is I'm going to become the student. I am going to become the student so I can teach you at another higher level. And that was really neat to be on the court and having somebody look at my game and help me tweak it. And it felt great. It felt a lot of really, really good. So that's it. I'm going to be hanging out here in Miami for a couple days now, visiting my sister. And I'm going to be doing my shadow strokes. And I'm just gonna be thinking about how I can take my stroke, my new forehand a little further so I can help you guys take your forehand a little better. Take care and have a great day.